Well, he was he's getting a few words there from the Italian coach. And I think, like I said, I think nerves might have just been there, just wanting to set up properly. And sometimes you have to, you know, play some tactics in early, you know, just to make sure you're getting some attacks in or beating your opponent, maybe to get some penalties up on the board. And it gives you a little bit more time to set up then. But it was a good win for him.
Yes, well-timed counter-attack. So that puts Schiraudi to the next round, round two.
Next contest, the 48 kilogram in white from Croatia. So
this is the last of round one preliminary matches between Antonin Divoracek of the Czech Republic in white and Nikola Vidovic from Croatia in blue. And here you can see Divoracek is working on a Sankaku Jimmy, a triangle hold. He's working hard to turn over Vidovic.
Yeah, it looks to be quite strong there, but it didn't have the effect, did it, on his opponent? He looked quite safe. Well, we've got a left versus right here. Oh, and well, there was a score there for the Czech player. For me, I thought he'd took control of his opponent and took him down there. Mm-hmm. Yeah, they popped that one on there. So Dvorak takes the lead.
Oh, nice Tanya Toshi from Dvorak. It's a good answer to his opponent's Haragoshi attempt.
A winner of the tournament, 3-1 from Croatia, Ana Victoria Bujic. Next contest, Ana Victoria Bujic.
A little bit of over rotation from that drop, so it's for Haragoshi.
René Maas, in blue from Great Britain, May Bostock.
All right, now, Mate, they were out of bound. Now you can see Vidovic is working on a Jujigatami. And his opponent stood up, so referee called Mate. Another Kouchigaki attempt. Oh, no score for Divoracek.
Winner at Tatami 2 in white from Israel, Tal Alhazov. Next contest, 155 kilogram on Tatami 2. In white from Belarus, Yafin Vitkowski. In blue from Bulgaria, Risto Ristov.
The referee changed that to Ippon. Was an action earlier where Vidovic came on, came down, and then